YouTube is engineered to help drive your customers to take action. This is done with 1. TrueView for Action, our clickable video format with customizable call to actions and headlines. 2. High intent audience types that help you reach the right people at the right time. And 3. Conversion measurement that helps you understand the full value of your campaign. In this video, you'll learn how to set up your TrueView for Action campaigns with the best practices. TrueView for Action encourages interested customers to learn more about your product, ask for a quote, or even add a product to their cart, thanks to a clickable and customizable call to action button that leads directly to your website. These campaigns only run with a skippable ad format. Before starting your campaign, make sure to set up your TrueView for Action campaign in the same account as your search and display campaigns. In addition, TrueView for Action campaigns require Google Ads conversion tracking in order to measure all relevant conversions coming from your campaigns. Even if you're using Google Analytics for your search campaigns, make sure to use Google Ads conversion for your TrueView for Action campaigns, since Google Analytics might not measure all of your YouTube conversions. Let's get started. In the Campaigns tab, click the plus button and start a new campaign. Note that you won't be able to find a campaign type called TrueView for Action. Instead, select either Sales, Leads, or Website Traffic Goal. Choose Video as your campaign type and click Continue. Enter a name for your campaign. Now set your bidding strategy. TrueView for Action campaigns work only with target CPA or maximize conversions. Choose target CPA if you already know your target CPA for video. If you're running TrueView for Action for the first time, choose maximize conversions. If starting with target CPA, it's important to define the right target CPA for your campaign. If you're running an existing video campaign that uses conversion tracking, you can start with the reported target CPA for that campaign. If you only run display or search campaigns, set a conservative target CPA that is 2 to 3 times your generic search CPA. Now set your daily budget. If you're using maximized conversions as your bidding strategy, it's recommended that your daily budget is 10 times your reported CPA. If you're using target CPA, it's recommended that your daily budget is 20 times your target CPA. These budget settings allow enough conversions for smart bidding to adjust and learn. You can set the start and end dates of your campaign if needed. Many advertisers use this type of campaign as an always-on campaign, in which case there's no need to define dates. Keep scrolling down. Don't forget to set your targeted languages and location. Now enter a name for your ad group. When thinking about your audience strategy, it's recommended to start your first campaign with audiences like custom intent and remarketing, as these high-intent audiences have shown lower CPAs compared to other audiences. Since audience is discussed in greater depth in a different Google Ads tutorial, let's jump straight to creating your video ad. Scroll down to create your video ad. Enter your video URL. Enter the final URL. Enter the display URL, which can be a shorter version of the final URL, or the same as the final URL. Enter a 10-character call to action. This should be compelling and direct people to the website specified in the final URL. Enter your 15-character headline. This will appear as the primary line of text that promotes your product or service. Click Create Campaign. It's important to create at least 5 variants of your video ad to allow the system to experiment and show the better performing variants more often. These 5 variants could be different creative assets or even the same creative with different call to actions or headlines. To further optimize your video ads, add site link extensions to make them even more useful and actionable. You can add site link extensions at the account, campaign, or ad group level within the Ads and Extensions tab and under Extensions. After your campaign starts running, it's important you wait 7 to 14 days to allow smart bidding to adjust before making any changes. For more step-by-step videos on Google Ads implementation and optimization, check out Google Ads tutorials. If you have any questions or for more information, please visit Google Ads Help.